Hi, in this video we are going to look at the new Grand Ceremony event in King of Avalon. This event is similar to events we've seen in the past. I think the most recent edition was the Workers' Barbecue event. So it has two shops where you can buy all kind of items at the credits in the, what I like to call the free shop, is are very easy to get by just killing monsters, valiant barbarians, gathering resources, harvesting resources from your resource production buildings. And the Witcher shops, you can get some credits each day of the event, so each of those 7 days, by doing some for that day specific events. So let's first, some specific actions, sorry. So let's first look at the shops. In a few editions ago of this event, the free shop was still quite nice, but already last time it was not so interesting, and now it's also, that has not improved, let's put it like that. The most interesting things you can get are, in my eyes, the gemstone essence and statue material. At this moment I have a lot of gemstone essence, actually, because that's also for the alliance siege the default reward. And statue material I don't have a lot at all, but actually this 2000 times 20 is not going to make a huge difference, unfortunately. For the rest, for me there's a little bit of speed ups. Probably I'm going to be able to grab everything I want again, but there's not really that much that I want, which is unfortunate. Of course, the Wishes shop has some more interesting ingredients. Dragonflame orb is very nice, but it's not that many and it is relatively expensive. Similar for Royal Badges, very nice, but very expensive. And Intensity Crystal 6 as well, very nice, but very expensive. And there are a lot of ingredients that you need to upgrade your various things that you have. Avalon Amber I currently have a lot, but that is normally quite interesting. Of course, statue material is quite interesting, but I find it a bit to buy it here from this shop. Not sure I'm going to do that. It feels like you should take this opportunity to grab even rarer things. The gemstone essence, same as for statue material, plus I currently have quite a lot of gemstone essence. Sun heart, a bit similar. I actually need some, but I probably am going to try to get everything I need from the lucky shot instead of buying it here. Adamantite, same, I'm going to try to get some from the lucky shot. Meteorite, iron, it's all quite interesting. Silver obsidian, emblem essence, it's all quite interesting, but we are going to have a limited amount of credits at the end of the week, and I don't think I'm going to want to buy those. So silver obsidian, emblem essence, similar. So now we get to the more, to the, my eyes, most interesting things. If you look at it from combat boost increase point of view, then enhancing things, upgrading things is nice, but what is really nice, if you can go to the next level, if you have a new emblem, for example, if we can buy this Waterdeck manuscript, if we can buy all of these at the end of the week, will cost quite a bit, 2300, but then we can have two Waterdrake manuscript, two Waterdrake emblems, and that's quite nice. That is really going to be a huge difference in stats, and from there normally you can also upgrade it one or two levels even. For apocalyptic statue, I still need one of those, and that is, it is actually very nice, but I might just wait this out, because we can buy some apocalyptic statue arcana every 2 days. Besides that, we get sometimes some mini events like the Excalibur event, the King First Kingdom, and the Ultimate Alliance Conquest. So not sure. Similar for Dream Arcana, I only need one more set of gemstones to convert into Dream, my defensive gemstones. Still need quite a lot. I still need 161 Arcana, but I'm not sure whether I'm going to buy that here. I cannot even buy enough for everything. There's only 100. If I have a lot, okay, maybe I will do it. Advanced Dream Arcana, I still find that expensive. So you pay 600 and for that you only get 50. So you have to pay 2,400 in total. Yeah, especially considering that might take me 4 more months. I don't want to do that. I prefer in that case to just spend it on the Water Drake emblem. These are of course nice and relatively, I feel that it's not that expensive to get Torrent Ascendant Scrolls 100 for 300 credits. And the Destruction Ingot also has been quite a bit cheaper than in the previous edition of this event. So that's also going to be definitely a possibility to consider. Maybe if I don't have enough to go to the Water Drake manuscript, I might go for some of these options. I doubt I will have enough to do to go for both, but yeah, who knows where I end up. It depends a bit what kind of events they throw at us. For now, I'm just going to try to get as much as possible. For the rest, it's not that other stuff is not interesting, but I think relatively, yeah, not so interesting, or there are other ways to get it. Okay, what I wanted to do now, I almost forgot before we start this whole process for improving my account for the event, because as we go along today, I'm already going to improve some gemstones. So I want to have a look at what are my stats now before we start this event, and in 1 week make a comparison at the end of the event to see how much we have been able to improve it. Most of the time the improvement that I have on my account is quite slow in between different editions of this event, but during this event I just save up a lot of stuff and use it all during this event, and that is normally the moment where my where I really increase the stats of my account. I was just collecting some I was just collecting some information for my website, and then I tend to not have this hero active, Isolde Fair, because I cannot get the accurate numbers for the resource requirements. I went there to switch a couple of my heroes to. Okay, then I think I'm all set and ready to attack my farm. So we can see that those stats as a reference that we can use next week. So let's now look at the specific stages for today. Of course, every day we get some login reward. That is just a few of those credits, those balloons. But yeah, just grab it. Why not? Today is about improving the gemstone score. I'm going to try to improve that quite a lot because I have a lot of gemstone essence. And it's about the lucky shot. I'm going to try to use 50 lucky shot coins to get those first four rewards. So looking at the, let's take a break again to look at this. Store it as my favorite. We can look a bit, I will look again at it later. So this is the improvements or the stats that I have so far. I think my inventory defense and health is maybe a bit lower as it has been because I've changed the heroes that I have leading my march. I'm focusing a lot on cavalry damage and bowman damage in general. Currently for the Alliance research, we're also pushing for that. We have maxed bowman damage 1 and 2 and are currently on our way to start with bowman damage 3. So that's quite interesting. Okay, those are the stats. We will have another look at it in about 1 week probably, when this event is close to ending. So now let's have a look at the lucky shot. I actually want a couple of things from the lucky shot. I want to get some glory fragments, 12, some adamantite, 33, and some sunheart, 197. And I want, ideally, I want to do that by only spending 50 lucky shot coins. So I'm first going to go, oh, that's the Eternal Flame, and Silver Obsidian, yeah, this is the Glory Fragment, first going to look at that, and normally we want to find this field, so I need 12, so getting this once is okay. Normally you get it on the third shot, but if you are lucky, maybe you can get it on the second or even sometimes the first shot. So that's done. And then the adamantite. Recently they changed this. We have to wait again until we have the lowest amount of adamantite. So now that is 18. Previously, I think that was also 7 or something. So they increased that in one of the recent updates. So that's nice. So I need 33. So I need to get those rewards twice. That is one time. And two times. So now the rest we are going to do on the gemstone. And also there it's meant, oh, I'm lucky, find it right away. And reset and start again. I'm hoping I'm getting lucky one of the times. Otherwise, I have to spend a bit more lucky shot coins. That would be a waste. Or I have to do less than I wanted with my gemstone upgrade. It would be a pity as well. Last time, I was quite lucky with this. I even got on time that on the first hit I already got the rewards that I wanted. And two times on the second hit, I believe, so that's really very lucky. But no such luck this time. You can actually, if you do this, decide, okay, if you get this 297,000, this is actually the second reward. If you get it first, you do another, start another group of another group, so you stop. That is not a bad tactic. So let's look at where we are at. So still a bit more to spend anyway. And for the I have 281, and what I actually would like is 288. So I think, yeah, it seems I'll have to just spend a bit more than I planned. Ideally, I now get it, the Schoenhardt in the second shot, or even the first, but yes, lucky. So now I only spent 51 and still got the, so I got the reward for the 50, and I got all the Schoenhardt that I need. So what I plan to do, I have five precious Dreamstone gem that I all want to upgrade one level. As I said, I have quite some gemstone essence, so that's quite nice. This cost me well, a fair amount for each, but I have plenty at the moment. And the total okay, and now I can do one more, getting one of them to, which is another nice, the others were about 10% increase in the cavalry bowman attack, and this is another 15% increase, so that's quite nice. I'm going to do one more to the rare level. And if my calculations were correct, this should indeed give me the first five rewards. So I'm I did some preparation work for this, so I look, okay, what is my current score, what is my high score, to be sure there is no mismatch. Sometimes there can be a mismatch that your high score is actually higher than your current score. You have to take that into consideration. And then I looked at okay, what can I do? And I don't want to spend too much, then I'd rather save it for next time. But in this this way, as you can see, I had 100,000 points was the limit, was one of the reward limits, and I chose a combination to get 100 and 1,000 points. This you can all prepare in advance, those points, the score increase is all can all be found in those recommended news articles. Where you can see the gemstone scores of each levels, and also for all other features of the game. So that allows you to to plan ahead like I did, and make sure you don't spend enough and you have exactly enough. I'm probably going to make a couple more videos this week about this event. It's quite, I always find it quite interesting, and it's really a way for me to improve my account further. One thing I wanted, I mean, if you're interested and I'm not fast enough with making a video on a certain topic, you can look back at the videos I made earlier on this workers' barbecue and also previous editions of this event. Actually, I forgot the names, but there should be plenty in my channel. The workers' barbecue being the most recent, so that's most likely to be most similar to the current event. And there you can also look at the different stages. Normally the stages are not necessarily happening in the same order, but the stages are normally quite quite similar. So if you need any help on another stage of this event, and I haven't made a new video yet, just look up those old videos, and they should still be quite helpful. What else, what I wanted to show as well is that and there are certain ways you can still get some ingredients besides from the S-shops for this event itself. So sometimes it can also be good to use already the credits to buy some things that can help you improve your accounts further and get you more credits. But what can also help, for example, is this Niederfall shop. Normally for my gold coins, I use it to buy Philosopher's Stones. I find those very useful, also save them up for this event, but I have already purchased them. But what is certain items you can also just purchase for the for those silver coins. So you could, for example, if you like me have a lot of those silver coins, you could say, hey, I'm going to buy 1,000 60-minute training speed-ups if there's going to be a training stage, which is of course always nice, and that just cost 75,000, so I could easily buy that. Some summoning horns could be good if you feel like, hey, I need some more summoning horns to get the rewards for that event stage. That will be nice. You have emblem essence, could be helpful. What I'm probably going to buy is the steel and a little bit of meteorite iron if there is going to be a stage where I'm going to upgrade, where you get points for upgrading your gear. That's probably what I'm going to do. I would like to get one of my hegemony pieces to go from +1, +2 to +3, and I need a bit more, or quite a bit more, steel for that, and a bit more meteorite iron. So consider buying some things here as well. Definitely worth it, and it's definitely worth to participate in the Niederfall. Normally, when we play it this season, there have only been mismatches. First two times, no opponent showed up at all. Last time, we had a much too strong opponent, way stronger than we were. Before that, we had an opponent that was way weaker than we were. And in both cases, we agreed with our opponents that in the first situation, our opponent was just gathering in a few buildings to get their 1,000 points. And in the last situation, we did that. We were just gathering in a few buildings so all of us could get our 1,000 points. And we just used the last 5 minutes to do some actual battle. Because sometimes there's just such a mismatch that you can just say, okay, it doesn't really make sense to do battle, and you're just nice for your opponent, and one time you're nice for your opponent, the other time another opponent pays it back to you. So I find it very good this way. Everybody at least can still get their 1,000 points, which still gives you quite some gold and silver coins as rewards, and you can still benefit from it. Would be nice if the matching up was better, but that's maybe very difficult for the game makers to do. Okay, it was a bit more talking about other stuff, but definitely interested in this event. If you have any comments or any questions, that's much appreciated. And thanks for watching this video.